I know a lot of y'all don't know I was locked up for 6 years. And this is why I enjoy my life, man. You never know how much shit means to you until you lose it. Man, and when I was locked up, man, I just missed little shit. I ain't want no big shit. I wanted like an iron. Got tired of being there, wrinkle-ass clothes. And then if I would've got this iron, I would've made so much money with this iron. You know how many motherfucking hot pastrami sandwiches you can make with an iron? Like, I've been there pressing out grilled cheese all motherfuckers. And then weird things happen in prison. Weird things happen in prison. I got, man, a lot of shit happened to me. I got, I almost killed an officer in there. Got locked up for assault on the officer, attempted assault on the officer. Let me tell you why. Because most people wouldn't even know I've been to prison until you make me mad. And then I'm gonna try to go there with your ass. So, officer, he's mad at me. Like, today in the world, in this city, people be mad at me because people like me. I'm cool, I'm a good performer, whatever. People get mad at me because of that. In prison, they got mad at me because I was what they called a writ writer. I wouldn't let nobody fuck over you. If somebody fuck over you, come talk to me. I'm gonna get on the grievance, and then all of a sudden you ain't gonna be getting fucked over no more, okay? And I was a pretty, you know, connected person there. You fuck with me, you probably won't wake up in the morning. That's on the shrimp. You fuck with me, nigga, a bag of coffee, your ass is gone. So, the dude was named Mitchell. And I'm coming through the corridor, and he sees me out of nowhere, pulls me over, like on a routine traffic stop or some shit. Yo, pull over, right here, stand on the wall. I'm standing on the wall, I'm like, what's up? And he say, I'm a strip searcher, you may have contraband on you. I said, no, you're not. No, you're not gonna strip search me. Not in front of everybody, you got it fucked up. So he says, I am gonna strip search you, you gotta pull over, cool. I ain't tripping, because when I first got to prison, an old school cat told me, he said, hey man, anything that you own on commissary, they can't make you take off without a valid reason, so buy you some white shorts. And I said, cool, bought me some white shorts. First thing I bought, I always showered in my shorts, and I always had my shorts on. Nigga, you get in the shower with me, nigga, I'm in the shower like this. You ain't got shit to see on me, nigga. Ain't nothing attractive about these white shorts. So, had on my shorts, so I'm thinking I'm cool. I'm cool, got my shorts on. So Mitchell strips me down, got my shorts on. I say, cool, we good. Ain't nothing you can do at this point. No, you're gonna have to take some shorts off. No, that's where you fucked up at. So I'm becoming a ticking time bomb at this point because the man is trying to make me get naked in the hallway. And I am probably one of the most dignified people in this prison. Dignified. I am what they call a SSI. Is what you are when you're in prison, when you're a janitor. SSI gives you the privilege of a broom and you can go around the whole motherfucking prison. So I am very important in this prison. Nigga, a Mexican will kill you behind me, nigga. Cause how you think he gonna get them cigarettes if I don't go get them, nigga? So I'm coming through. And I'm like, okay, so the motherfucker is gonna try to strip me down. And I'm enraged. Sergeant comes through and say, I can't go against my CO. You're gonna have to comply with stripping. And I told the officer in his eyes, if you strip me down, this is gonna be the worst thing in your life. He said, is that a threat? I say, that is a promise. So now, all the Muslims that's on my building have come in to the corridor. So now it's 65 Muslims standing on the wall because I'm in second in command of the Muslims on this unit. And nigga, I am tears is running down my fucking face because I'm that enraged because I know I'm never going home. Because I've gave this motherfucker my word. Nigga, so the ordeal happens. I ain't talked to nobody for 2 days. And them motherfuckers had me on watch. They was watching me in sections. They like, keep up with the nigga. He ain't talking. And my best friend is in here. He know. Nigga, if you ever, if motherfucker ever get into it with me, if you ever hear these words, I got into it, Ali. Y'all was talking loud in public? Yeah. You ain't get into it with him. Did that nigga go silent? Yeah, he did stop talking. Ooh, shit. Nigga finna trip. Cause now I'm contemplating in my mind how I'm gonna kill you and get away with it. So I'm chilling. And then this dude, I done plotted my plan. I found out earlier that day that Mitchell is working the gate going to fourth building where nobody is at, because that's closed custody building. Nigga, I am excited. I'm on 7th building. I got to get the 4th building. Have no way to get the 4th building because it's going to be an out-of-place case. Don't want to get out of place. I just want to kill this motherfucker. So I'm walking around with my knife taped to the side of my body trying to figure out a way to get the 4th building. Boom, here it is. This dude gets in trouble going to closed custody. I see him. I say, Pete, where you going? He said, I gotta go to closed custody. 4th building? Yeah. Let me carry your mattress. He got his shit in a white bucket. I got the mattress over my shoulder this way. So you can't see my face. And I'm walking with the mattress, got my knife, nigga, and I'm so excited because I come around the corner and Mitchell's standing there and he gotta open the gate for this boy. And I'm like, ooh. Unstrap my knife while I'm walking, got my knife out. Nigga, do you know 7 Muslim brothers came around the corner, caught me. Ali! It is satisfactory enough for me when I dropped the mattress, Mitchell saw me and closed that gate. The terror in his eyes was enough. That motherfucker did, I was on that unit for another year. That motherfucker never said nothing to me again. And I just used to walk by him and say, Ali! That motherfucker was lucky. But it wasn't him. I was the lucky one. Because I would have been in that motherfucker. I was already in there crazy as hell. I used to be in prison